Scuba Tech Tips. Here I am back at Aquarius Diving Center in Toronto, one of the biggest and best dive stores in the whole country. Kevin laughs at me because I can't say the word myth, whatever. Scuba myths. One of the scuba myths is that you should not store your scuba tank laying on its side, or you should. Which is it?
Should
not. Kevin says that there's a myth that you should not store the scuba tank lying on its side. It should be stored standing up. And of course, if you look around the dive store, Kevin will show you, if you look around the dive store, and there's a picture coming up, all scuba tanks are always stored standing up. Well, there's a simple reason why they're stored, except for these ones, Kev. There's a simple reason why they're stored standing up. They don't take up as much room. In any kind of business, floor space is critical. So why would you store 50 or 60 scuba tanks on their side when you can stand them up, take up quarter of the room? But anyway, I was just wondering. Anyway, let's deal with the myth. The myth is, apparently, that you should not store your scuba tanks on the side. Well, why would that myth exist? Well, there's a reason for it, okay? The whole reason, the bottom line, the premise for the myth is that if there's a corrosion in the tank, if there's any water or any other contaminants in the scuba tank, and the tank is laying on its side, where the side walls are very thin relative to the bottom, that water or corrosion or whatever it is that's in there that's not good for the tank is eating through a very thin wall. Yes, yeah, and that's quite true, actually. It's quite true. That premise is true. This is an aluminum tank, which is not the best example. This is an aluminum tank, and you see on this aluminum tank, the sidewall here is about a half an inch. In fact, it's almost exactly half an inch. I just measured it. The bottom, however, you can see how it's curved, you see? The bottom, however, down here is quite a bit thicker, at least three quarters, maybe more than that. So the myth is that if you store the tank upright, sitting on the ground, right, any moisture or corrosive material, anything bad, is sitting on the thick bottom. And that same applies to a steel tank, too. Steel tanks are very similar, but their walls are much, much thinner. A steel tank wall is not a quarter of an inch. And the bottom is probably maybe 3/16, maybe as much as a half. So with a steel tank as well, the bottom is much thicker. So the myth has existed for a long time, actually, that if you're storing your tank for a long time, simply stand it up. Any moisture or any other corrosive material sits on the bottom, and the bottom is quite thick, so it won't burn through the bottom and possibly explode. Well, let's deal with a couple of other things. First of all goes back to storing your tank. Let's deal with how long you're going to be storing it. Generally speaking, in a dive store like this, where we have tanks up and down and so on, it's short term. Even for most divers, it's relatively short term. By short term, I mean less than 6 months. If for some reason, hopefully not, you're not going to be diving for a long time, shall we say a year or more, how do you store your tanks? Well, number one, you should let the air out. No, not all the air. I didn't say that. Careful, you guys. I know you're going to come after me. Let most of the air out. Not all of it. Retain 100, 150, 200 PSI. So let most of the air out. Let it out slowly so you don't get condensation on the inside. That can happen. Go back to my tech tips. You'll see that. Let the air out very, very slowly, but make sure there's a little bit of air left. Always want to be able to open the valve and hear a bit of air coming out. If you can open the valve a little bit and a little bit of air comes out, nothing can get in, okay? Step one, let most of the air out. Next, step two, how do you store? Laying down or standing up? Well, you know what? I don't care about the myth. It all comes down to how much room do you have to store your tank? If you're short on room, stand it up. First of all, it's highly unlikely there's moisture in there. If there was moisture in there, if you've been doing your annual visual and being a little bit careful with your tank, as most divers are, there's not going to be much moisture in there. And now you've let most of the air out. When you let the air out, a lot of that, if there is moisture, it's water vapor. It's not water in there, it's water vapor. That has come out as well. So you have very, very little water vapor in there, water, and very little, it should be no water at all, very little water vapor. So the likelihood of you getting much rusting in there or corrosion, if it's an aluminum tank, is very, very unlikely. So stand it up on its end, sure. The bottom is thicker. Heaven forbid it pools down there and it burns a little hole in the bottom. Not likely going to happen. Why do they say, some people would say lay it on its side? And I don't disagree with that. Well, the thing is this. As I said earlier, if you lay it on the side, the side is not as thick, right? So any corrosive material, water, whatever, is it only has a very short distance to burn through. That's true. But you forget that now has over 2 feet of surface. That's right. If it's standing on its end and there's a bit of moisture, it's concentrated in 1 inch. All the corrosion occurs in one little spot. And if you lay it on its side, same amount of moisture, that moisture spread over 2 feet. Which is more likely to burn through? Which is more likely to cause corrosion? Which is more likely to be a problem? Really, there's not much difference. Lay it on its side, you have a much, much bigger surface. On its end, you have a much thicker bottom. It's already, it's a wash. Comes back to you. You got lots of room? Lay it on its side. You have much room? Stand it up. I personally don't think it'd be much of a problem either way. When it goes back into service, first thing you do, into the diastore for a visual. Make sure there's no problem in there. If it is, if there's been a bit of moisture, a little bit of corrosion has occurred because of that bit of air you had in there, touch of moisture, they'll clean it, pass it, and off you go diving again. So don't get too worked up about whether you should store a tank on its end or on its side. Don't get too right. It's not a big deal. The myth, don't store it on its side. Well, it's a myth. Alec Pierce, Scuba Tech Tips. Talk to you soon, guys.